The video is Le'ilu Nishmas v'Shmuel Baruch Mechaim Tzidoy Terbo Bruvein Ben Shmuel Yomtev and Afur Shem Techai Fuma Bas Per Melia Malka. We are on our way to Eretz Yisrael. Maybe when this video reaches you, we'll be in Eretz Yisrael. To my Chavusa Shloishim, and I want to focus a little bit on Inyanei Avelus Shloishim Matzevah. Very interesting customs, and many times people get confused what is halacha, what is not halacha. Chas v'shalom, that's one thing for sure, not to fight. You know, sometimes people fight over Kaddish. Who's going to take the Amud? Who's going to be the Chazan? Who's going to lead the davening? And many times, it's actually a dispute. When it comes to Hilchas Avelus, it's confusing. There are many opinions. When to do the Matzeva, when not to do the Matzeva. When to commemorate the Yahrzeit, is it based on 12 months, is it based 12 months from the time of burial, the time of death? Everything in Hilchas Avelus seems to have opinions. But it's kedai, of course, to ask your local rabbi and to follow what he says, but never fight. Just give you an example, an incredible halacha that's brought down, that if someone, for example, is fighting over the Amud, he's fighting over Kaddish, you know, in some congregations, only one Avel, only one mourner says a Kaddish. So whoever is what's called a Chiv, or a what's called someone that is a stronger candidate. So for example, if someone is in his Shloshim, as opposed to someone who's in Yud Beis Chodesh, someone who's in the 30 days since the passing, someone's in 12 months since the passing, so he overrides the person that is in 12 months. So without getting into detail, if someone would steal, so to speak, and take the Kaddish from the other person, that's not a problem. Meaning, for the person that seemingly lost, that Kaddish goes to the person that was supposed to daven. So there's no gain. Not only that, think for yourself, right? If we really thought about it, if we just took ourselves for a moment and said, wait a minute, I'm doing this because what? We have to discuss exactly what this Kaddish does. So there are sources of what it does. On a simple level, Kaddish is based on a Midrash with Rabbi Akiva. Blined will speak about it more, about the power of Kaddish, what it does, based on Halacha, based on Kabbalah. But for sure, whatever it's doing, it's supposed to be giving Nachas Ruach to the parent or whoever passed away. Now, can you imagine that person's in Shemaim, knows the truth, and would see that the person that's saying Kaddish for them is fighting over it? That would certainly not give Nachas Ruach. And this is brought down, this concept. So we always have to think a little bit deeper and not fight. So now, I want to focus on Shloishim, specifically Shloishim and Akamas Matzeva. There is actually, I would call it it's called Minag Balabatim. In fact, that's the way the Stipe used to refer it to what's called the unveiling. Unveiling doesn't seem to have any source in Halacha. A perfect example is something that people make a big deal of, but actually has no significance. There is no such thing as a Jewish unveiling. What happens is that there are specific times when one should go up to the kever, to the cemetery where the person was buried. Those times are after the 7 days of Avelus, after 30 days, and on the Yahrzeit. Those are the main days. Now, because there's three different opinions when to place the matzeva, so when person is placing the matzeva, meaning setting the stone and putting whatever you're writing on the matzeva, which in itself is a whole story, what to write, that is when they used to daven, they used to say Tehillim, they used to say Hespedim. And that's why there's a significance to that day, but otherwise there is no significance to just unveiling, showing, putting up the matzeva. Now, it could be, and it's always important to validate every minig, and especially when it comes to matzeva, not clear what exactly is the halachic and maybe Kabbalistic significance of matzeva. Now, on a simple level, if you look at the Yerushalmi in Kiddush in Shkalim, the Yerushalmi in Shkalim says actually very interesting that a matzeva is not needed for a Talmud Chacham or a Tzaddik. Why not? Because the simple understanding of a matzeva is a reminder, a memory of the person that passed away. So the person should, now, that's why there are those that have the custom not to put it up until 12 months, because for 12 months, the neshama is back and forth, and a person who is a mourner, for example, for a parent, is thinking about that person all the time. 12 months, Chazal say that the mace is not mishtakech min alev, doesn't leave the heart. After 12 months, it doesn't, definitely need a reminder. But a tzaddik, their actions, their good deeds, is what is keeps the memory. Now, the custom, of course, is, you see, that especially sometimes the bigger the tzaddik is, the bigger the matzeva is. But we need to first begin with understanding the matzevah, the purpose. The purpose is to remind, to remember this person, to be able to live the legacy of this person. There's another purpose of the matzevah, and it fits with shloshim. So let's speak about shloshim specifically. Shloshim is the time where people go to the grave and they have the matzevah set up and they say hespedim and they daven and they try to give nachas ruach and a closure. There is an actual closure to the neshama. At this point, by the shloshim, the neshama, according to some svarim hakdoshim, you could look it up in the sources. The Nitei Gavril, of course, has all these sources. Is the sefer called Hadas Kodesh that describes as a closure. At this point, the neshama goes into Gan Eden, and the relatives wish him mazel tov. And at that point, they are set. The neshama is set. This is just a little bit. Anyone who has any questions about these interesting menhagim, please know that we're going to try to address them. Hatzlacha, and we shall only hear b'sorot tovos.